Hello, folks. I'm Chief Meteorologist Darby Bobby with the 4029TV.com forecast on this Monday, April the 1st. It is a severe day for good reason. We're very much worried about that risk of severe storms this evening and overnight, particularly between 6 p.m. and 2 a.m. The core of the risk looks to be in northwest Arkansas, but we definitely have plenty of potential in the River Valley as well. We'll all need to be prepared. If we've got a tornado warning, you got to get in that safe spot as quickly as possible. Make sure you know where that is at home. And make sure you're kind of going through that, all the procedures with the family. If a tornado warning gets issued, you want to get everyone there as quickly as possible. That's got to be a first floor, as low down as you can, as many walls in between you and the outdoors as possible. If you have a storm shelter or basement, that's great. Most people don't. So just getting into that interior room, as many walls between you and the outside as possible. And that could be a closet, could be a bathroom, could be anything. Whatever that room happens to be is the room you want to be in that's most centralized in the house. Of course, if it's a severe thunderstorm warning, you just kind of stay indoors and away from windows is pretty much what you want to do. You don't want to be traveling around, obviously, this evening. During this time, we're going to have the bulk of our risk. Spotty shower or two through the afternoon, early evening, but the bulk of it, again, after 6 p.m. Here we are at 8 p.m., latest from our high-resolution rapid refresh model. We're watching for all modes of severe weather here, too. Big-time hail. Could be the big stuff. Particularly damaging winds, strong tornado or two is a possibility. So certainly a significant threat here. We'll be on top of it throughout the evening at 4029. If we've got warnings, we'll make sure we're telling you about it. But of course, you can see there we are at 8 p.m. Some initial storms starting to pop in northwest Arkansas, River Valley as well. Later on after that, here we are at 10 p.m. Could be very active at that time. Some supercell thunderstorms in the mix. Those are the rotating storms producing the biggest hail and generally producing with the greatest threat of tornadoes with it as well. So we'll have some of that in the area, watching all of this very carefully through 10, 11 p.m., midnight. Still could have some activity in the area, even through about 1 or 2 in the morning. Still could be something left over. After that, starting to clear off to the east, cooler air coming in behind this system, waking up 50s and 60s tomorrow morning, a little cooler. And then a lot of cloud cover, breezy throughout the day. That cooler air keeps pushing. I think we'll probably be in the low 50s in northwest Arkansas, even upper 40s by 3 or 4 p.m. I think upper 50s in the River Valley. You want that jacket tomorrow. I think we'll be cooler than what these numbers are showing right here. So you'll want that jacket. And then we get into Wednesday morning, waking up in the 30s to around 40 across northwest Arkansas in the River Valley. Still a bit of a breeze. I don't think we'll get to a frost or freeze Wednesday morning, but it'll be chilly. And with that wind, could feel like it's in the 20s and 30s. And then we get into Wednesday afternoon. We don't warm a lot. We'll call it partly cloudy skies, some sunshine in there, but very breezy with highs in the 50s and low 60s. And then Thursday and Friday morning, that's when we get a chance for a frost or freeze, particularly in northwest Arkansas. We'll talk about that. Looking at the weather for solar eclipse day next Monday, that's, of course, very important, too. And we'll discuss that briefly. But we've got to stay on task here this evening, folks. We've got to stay focused on the risk of severe weather until it gets out of here. We'll have a complete update. 5, 6, and 10 on 4029, of course, at 9 p.m. on the CW.